Welcome back. So today we'll be studying about preparation of certain addition polymers. Now, just let me remind you, what are the addition polymers? Addition polymers are the polymers where the monomer units are just added up. Now, in this addition, there's no loss of small molecules, just the water molecules or the ammonia molecule. No loss of any type of molecules takes place. Simply, addition of the monomer units takes place to form the long chains. Now this addition reaction, it sometimes proceeds by the formation of a free radical, which may be a carbocation or a carbanion. And if this takes place, then it proceeds through three steps, that is the initiation, propagation and termination. So today we will not discuss in detail about the mechanism of addition polymerization, but we will be going through certain examples of addition polymerization, examples of certain addition polymers, that is how they are prepared. Now, if you are not clear with the mechanism of addition polymerization, you may go back to the previous video and you will be clear with that idea. So, let us begin with preparation of certain addition polymers. Now, when we talk about the addition polymers are again divided into several types. There are several types of addition polymers. Just let us see one of those types of addition polymers. So, first of all, we have the polyolefins. Polyolefins. Now what are polyolefins? Polyolefins, that means the polymers which are obtained from the olefins. So we can say polymers which are containing the unsaturated hydrocarbons, that is the olefins. So we can say polyolefins, we can define this, that is the polymers obtained from unsaturated hydrocarbons, that is olefins. Which type of unsaturated hydrocarbons? That is olefins. Now what are olefins? Olefins are the unsaturated hydrocarbons containing a carbon to carbon double bond. You will find that there will be a carbon to carbon double bond in case of the polyolefins. Now example of the polyolefins that we will be studying over here, the preparation, that is our polyethylene, which is also called as polyethylene. Then we will be studying about polypropylene and polystyrene. So we will be studying the preparation of polyethylene, polypropylene and polystyrene. The next type of addition polymer is the polydienes. That is, we have the polydienes. Polydienes. Now polydienes, the word itself tells us what does this polydiene means. That means the polymer containing the diene. Now what is a diene? That is an unsaturated hydrocarbon containing two double bond. That means these type of polymers are the polymers which will be containing the two double bond. The monomer unit will be having the two double bonds where there will be the starting material and it will form the long chain of the polymer. So we can say polymers of dienes, or we can say polymers containing the unsaturated hydrocarbons, or polymers obtained from unsaturated hydrocarbons containing two double bonds. Obviously, di means two and ie means what? Double bonds. Containing two double bonds. So, here these are the examples. There is this class of polymers they include. So, we can say this class of polymers include synthetic rubber, such as your neoprene unit. What is synthetic rubber? That is a neoprene unit containing the synthetic rubber, such as neoprene unit, and or another example is your Buna S. Synthetic rubber, that is such as neoprene or Buna S. So we'll be studying about preparation of Buna S over here. The next type of polymer, that is a poly polyolefins. Polyhalo olefins. Now what does it mean? Poly means the polymer chain. Halo means having the halogen group, and olefins. Olefins means a carbon to carbon double bond. There is olefins. There is a there will be double bond between carbon to carbon, unsaturated hydrocarbon. So we can say these are the polymers of halogen substituted. These are the polymers of halogen substituted alkenes. Now let me just explain you. Suppose if this is your alkene, okay, this is the alkene, ethene. So if we remove this hydrogen and we substitute with a halogen, look here what it will be. We can write it down, that is really, if it's also after substitution, it will be F2C. Fluorine is a halogen, that is CF2. Such type of polymer. So this long chain of this polymer, when it has been obtained, that comes under the polyhaloolefins. So obviously these are the halogen substituted alkenes. From the alkenes, we are substituting the hydrogen with a halogen. So here under this, we'll be studying about our polytetrafluoroethylene. Example of this type of polymer, that is polytetrafluoroethylene. There's no space, so we'll write it down here. Down. Example, that is polytetrafluoroethylene, which is also called as in short PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene, or polyvinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride. In short, we also write down this as PVC. Now PTFE in common name is also Teflon. Those non-stick cookwares, they are coated with Teflon. So that is a polymer. Polyvinyl chloride, PVC, those footwear which we wear during the rainy season. Those footwear, the soles of the footwear, that is made up of PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride. So we'll be studying the preparation of, or we are from this particular group, we'll be studying the preparation of polytetrafluoroethylene as well as polyvinyl chloride. And last type of addition polymer, I'm writing down over here at the top. That is polyacrylates. Fourth type, polyacrylates. So these are the polymers of acrylates, or we can say polymers which are obtained by polymerization polymerization of acrylic monomers. Polymerization of acrylic monomers. So these are, okay, from here we don't have to study any example, any preparation of any type from this, the last type. So it's not required, only you just need to know that is a definition, that is what are polyacrylates, and what does it include, that is these are the polymers obtained from acrylic monomer. That's it. Okay, where we don't need to study any examples from this particular type of polymers, it's not required. So we'll be studying about this as well as this and the third type, and over here the example, that is from here polyethylene and polypropylene and polystyrene. From polyethylenes we will be studying about BuNO-S, and from polyhaloolefins we'll need to study about polytetrafluoroethylene and polyvinyl chloride. These are extremely important. You'll find in the question paper always ask for 1 or 2 marks. And as far as this is concerned, this is just for your knowledge. I'm telling you that this is the last type of the addition polymer, the fourth type of the addition polymers, but it is not a part of a syllabus. You don't require to study about this. So let us begin with the study of all these types of polymers one by one. Let me rub the board.
Hello. 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 H
Okay, so we begin with the first type of polymer, that is the polyolefins, and under this we'll begin with the study of polyethylene. So let us just start with the preparation also. Again, I'm telling you what are the polyolefins. That is the polymers obtained from unsaturated hydrocarbons. This olefins, there will be carbon to carbon double bond in this. So our mono, so OBL, let's begin with the first example, that is polyethylene. Preparation of polyethylene. Now it can be prepared in two ways, that is number 1, that is the first example. It can be prepared in two ways, that is polymerization of the monomer unit under high pressure. Okay, so we will take the monomer unit, that is our ethane and molecules of, and we subject it to high pressure, that is 1000 to 5000 atmosphere, and the temperature maintained over here is 520 Kelvin in presence of oxygen 520 Kelvin, where we get our polyethylene, that is our polymer polyethylene. Okay, now the polyethylene that is obtained by this method, that is under high pressure, we also call it as a high pressure polyethylene, or it is also called as low density polyethylene. Now what happens in this particular case is that it has got round about 50 branches plus one long chain and no cross links. So look here what happens, because of so many branches, it is not possible for this structure to be packed compactly. So as this structure cannot be packed compactly, we will find that the density decreases. The polyethylene obtained in this way will be having the low density because of so many branches. Okay, so this is our first method of preparation of polyethylene, that is polymerization of the monomer unit. This is a monomer, that is N molecules of the ethane under high pressure. Next is polymerization under low pressure. Polymerization under low pressure. So again we take our same monomer unit, but the pressure will be low as compared to this. That is N molecules of ethane. We are taking N molecules of ethane, and the pressure that we use over here is 6 to 7 atmosphere. The temperature used is 343 Kelvin to 343 Kelvin. But again over here, one more thing that we use over here, that is we use a catalyst over here, that the name of the catalyst is Ziegler-Natta catalyst is used over here. Okay, and the polymerization takes place and we get over our required polyethylene. Okay, now what is Ziegler-Natta catalyst? Now Ziegler-Natta catalyst, it has been obtained, or the name has been given after the name of the scientist who prepared this catalyst. That is, it comes from, Ziegler comes from the word Carl Ziegler. And Natta comes from the word, that is your Giulio Natta. So these two people prepared this catalyst, that is a Ziegler-Natta catalyst, and hence the name is the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Now what is the Ziegler-Natta catalyst? It is composed of, it is a mixture of triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride. So it is in this way, that is titanium in the center and and three ethyl groups. So mixture of these two compounds is called as a Ziegler-Natta catalyst. You don't need to go into the detail of the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. You just need to know that this polymerization, that is formation of polyethylene under low pressure takes place by the use of Ziegler-Natta catalyst at an atmosphere of 6 to 7 atmosphere and 333 to 343 Kelvin, where we get our polyethylene. So this polyethylene prepared, or the polyethylene prepared in this way, this is a high density polyethylene. High density polyethylene. Now what happens, it has got the linear chains. This, so we can say this type, there is a polyethylene obtained in this way, this has got linear molecules. I'm writing down over here, it has got linear molecules. Look here, there's no space, so let me come over here. That is, it has got linear molecules. And along with the linear molecules, it has got very low branching. Linear molecules, low branching. So if the molecules are linear, linear molecules are there, branching is very less as compared to this one. As compared to the high pressure polyethylene, the branching is very less, and as the branching is very less, it is possible to compactly arrange this. The molecules can be compactly arranged. They can be packed compactly, and as they can be packed compactly, obviously the density over here increases, and hence this type of polyethylene, a polyethylene prepared under low pressure, we call this as high density polyethylene or the low pressure polyethylene, or and this another one is a high pressure and the low density polyethylene. Clear? So in this way, by two methods of polyethylene, our first polymer, it can be prepared. I'll rub the boat. I hope it's clear. We'll move on to the next type of addition polymers, and we are discussing the polyolefins. So we'll come to the next type of polyolefins, that is polypropylene. Preparation of polypropylene. So it is a polypropylene, it is a polymer of propylene. It is a polymer of propylene. That means the monomer unit used over here is a propene. Propene units, many units of propene that has been joined together to give us the polypropylene over here. So look here. In this, we are using it has been gathered as a monomer, has been taken in presence of your Ziegler-Natta catalyst. In presence of the Ziegler-Natta catalyst, where we get our polypropylene, that is CH. This CH3 comes over here, and this is over here CH2. So we get over here, that is our required polypropylene. Here over here, okay. So monomer unit, Ziegler-Natta, we are substituting to the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. So we'll be getting over here our required polypropylene, which is also called as, in short, we also call this as PP. Polypropylene in short is also called as PP. You will find in the question paper sometimes they don't use the full name, they'll be giving you the short name, so they just don't get confused. The next type of our polyolefin is our polystyrene. Polystyrene. In short, it is also called as styron. So, it has been prepared, it is a polymer of styrene. Now, what is it? It is a, first of all, it is a polymer of styrene. Now, what is styrene? That is C6H5, CH double bond CH2. if a benzene ring, C6H5 is nothing but is a benzene ring over here, if this benzene ring to that, if it is a CH, double bond CH2 that has been attached, that is called as the styrene. So we'll just look over here how that has to be prepared. Now let us take this, I'll just draw the structure for this preparation. So this is your C6H5, which you all of you all know over here. Now CH double bond CH2. So you will take N molecules of the styrene and will subject it to polymerization in presence of a catalyst. So it is subjected to polymerization. Which polymerization? Addition polymerization in presence of a catalyst. Now, there are various catalysts used depending on various reactions. One of the catalysts that has been used over here is butyl lithium. Butyl lithium is one of the catalysts. Usually details of the catalyst has not been asked because many catalysts been used depending on various conditions, but I'm just giving you the name of one of the catalysts, that is butyl lithium. We are adding the catalyst butyl lithium, and in the intermediate we also have to add some butadiene. So we don't need to go in detail, you just only need to know this equation over here, and we'll be getting over here this polystyrene. So we'll write down in this way, that is CH2, N molecules of this. So we get a polystyrene. Clear everyone? So this was a polystyrene. We'll proceed on to the next class. We come to the next class of preparation of the addition polymers, that is polydienes. As I already told you, what are the polydienes? These are the unsaturated hydrocarbons containing the two double bonds. So we can say polymers contain unsaturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated hydrocarbons containing two double bonds. That is diene. Diene means what? Hydrocarbons containing two double bonds, that is called as the polydiene. So under this, I told you there is a the two polymers that is included over here. There is a isoprene, or the that is a rubber, that is a synthetic rubber, and which is also called as the neoprene. Sorry. So here we have the neoprene and the Buna S. But neoprene preparation we don't need. Neoprene is what? It is a rubber units which has been joined together, but neoprene we don't need to study in detail. We need to study about Buna S. So we come to the first polydiene over here, that is your Buna S. Now Buna S, in short, it is also called as SBR. Now look here, what do we mean by Buna? Now it is a copolymer prepared from copolymer. It is a copolymer prepared from buta-1,3-diene and styrene. Now what is a copolymer? When the monomers used are two different monomers. When two different monomers are been used, then the resulting polymer which has been obtained, that is called as the copolymer. So it is a copolymer prepared from buta-1,3-diene and styrene. So we get this name Buna S. Look here, Buna S. BU for butadiene. NA for sodium. That is NA. So we are writing down, although we are writing down a small alphabet over here because we want to get one name over here. So this sodium is used as a polymerizing agent. It helps in the polymerizing process. It has been used as a polymerizing agent, and S stands for styrene. This S stands for styrene. which we are using over here. That is, we are preparing, we are taking glutamine-3-diene and styrene units over here. So it has been obtained by addition polymerization of a mixture. It is a copolymer prepared from glutamine-3-diene and styrene, and it has been prepared by addition polymerization. Addition polymerization. Obviously, we are studying all the addition polymers over here. So it has been prepared by addition polymerization of a mixture of glutamine-3-diene and styrene. These two compounds that we take as the monomers, and styrene. Okay, and here we take these compounds in an emulsion form. That is, in an I'm rubbing this out. So these compounds, they have been taken in an emulsion form, in an, so we can say in an emulsion system. The temperature used is 273 Kelvin in presence of a catalyst. Which catalyst? In presence of peroxide. Peroxide as a catalyst. So this is how we prepare Buna S. Now I'll just show you, there is a formula where there is a the reaction CH2 double bond CH 1,3-butadiene. So 1,3-butadiene. Look here, we are taking 1,3-butadiene plus styrene over here. So we'll be taking over here styrene, that is n molecules of 1,3-butadiene and n molecules of styrene. So CH double bond CH2. This is the n molecules of the styrene. Both of them, they have been joining together. I don't have much space over here, so I'm writing down over here. So that is CH2. This single bond will become CH double. This comes over here. That is CH2. Again, this one bond helps in joining of this. That is CH2. Again, this one bond. Again, it has to join to many number of chains, and over here this benzene ring that has to be attached over here. So look here. This is our required Buna S. Buna S. It is also called as SBR. SBR is what? In short, that is SBR. It is styrene butadiene rubber. SBR means styrene butadiene rubber. Okay, styrene butadiene rubber. Rubber is nothing. It is your isoprene units. Okay, there is a natural rubber. When it has been prepared synthetically, there is a neoprene unit. Neoprene we don't have in the syllabus. The preparation of neoprene we don't have to study. But this is what we have to study. That is the styrene butadiene rubber. Next class of addition polymers that we have to study over here is your polyhaloolefins. Now what is polyhaloolefins? That is a polymers of halogen substituted alkenes. These are the polymers of halogen substituted alkenes. I remind you once again, now this is a alkene. We are substituting it with an halogen. So this will be what? F2C double bond CF2. So this type of polymer, that is, this is a monomer unit that we are using over here. So look here, how will we be preparing? So it is a polymer. So first, under polyhaloolefins, we will be preparing our polytetrafluoroethylene. Polytetrafluoroethylene. In short, it is called as PTFE. Okay, In short, we call this PTFE, or the other name for this is also Teflon. As I told you, the coating on the non-stick cookware, there is nothing in there, but that is of Teflon. So it is a polymer of tetrafluoroethylene and has been prepared by free radical addition polymerization. Now in this free radical addition polymerization, if we say that what is a free radical addition polymerization, if you remember, we have used, that is a proceeds where the formation, that is a, it involves a carbocation as well as the carbonyl that can, that is act as a free radical over here. So it is prepared by free radical addition polymerization of tetrafluoroethylene under pressure polymerization of water and oxygen over here. In presence of water and oxygen. Now water and oxygen, which act as a free radical. These are acting as a free radical. So it initiates the reaction. So it is also, we can also call it as initiator. Initiator. Water and oxygen, this is a free radical that provides a free radical, and it also acts as an initiator. That is in presence of water and oxygen, which act as a free radical initiator. So that means what? From water and oxygen, we are getting our free radical. So we can say this is a free radical initiator. That is water and oxygen, it is a free radical. In this way also we can write down, that is free radical initiator. That means we get our initiator from water and oxygen. We get our initiator, which may be a free, which is a free radical, from water and oxygen. We don't need to go into the detail how it is. We just need to know this equation NCF2. So polymerization under high pressure. In presence of oxygen, we will be getting over here NF2C. So this is our PTFE or polytetrafluoroethylene. So high pressure in presence of oxygen, and in water medium, this oxygen acts as a free radical initiator. That means we will be getting the free radical because of this oxygen, from this oxygen over here. So next polymer, or the last polymer under addition polymerization that we will be studying, is our PVC, polyvinyl, or it is also called as the polyvinyl chloride. It also comes under this polyhaloolefins. So PVC, the second polymer over here under polyhaloolefins, that is polyvinyl chloride. Now what is this? That is, from the word itself, polyvinyl chloride, it suggests that it is the monomer unit used as a vinyl chloride. Now what is a vinyl chloride? That is N. Vinyl chloride is what? CH2 double bond CHCl. The compound containing this CH2 double bond CHCl, that is called as the vinyl group. So this is called as a vinyl chloride. So we are using this as a monomer unit, that is N molecules of CH2 double bond CHCl. In presence of pressure and a peroxide, under pressure we are preparing. Now this has to be prepared in an autoclave. Now what is an autoclave? Now autoclave is a machine in which the compound is heated under pressure. And the temperature has been controlled, but still it has to be heated at a high temperature under pressure. So we can say it is a machine that uses steam and steam under pressure. Now as I told you that the temperature has to be, it should be a high temperature. So how this high temperature has been created? By creating the steam. So we can say that is this particular autoclave, it is a type of a machine that uses steam. a machine that uses steam under high pressure. So we can see here that is the items are heated to an appropriate temperature or appropriate sterilization. Now this machine, suppose if in this preparation some microorganisms are also prepared, microorganisms also comes in contact, even those microorganisms also get killed, or in any process where the microorganisms are involved, such as your bacteria or virus or fungi, any microorganisms are involved in a chemical reaction, even then those materials are subject to autoclave. So what happens when those substances or when the materials are heated in an autoclave? They are heated with the help of steam under high pressure, where all the microorganisms also get killed over here. And over here in this, our main objective of heating this compound, the monomer unit in autoclave, is that we need to heat it under high pressure, and it has to be sterilized. That is a proper control temperature that has been given. That is a temperature for certain time. That is why we are heating it in autoclave. So our main purpose over here is not to kill the microorganisms. Although this autoclave can be used for killing of the microorganisms, our main purpose of using the autoclave over here is to be heating the compound, that is this monomer unit, under high pressure. So preferably we can use some other processes also, but preferably we are using an autoclave over here. So polyvinyl chloride, it has been heated under pressure in presence of peroxide as a catalyst, where we will be getting over here. Then look here, CH2CH, this will be our Cl, and so here we will getting the end molecules, and hence we call this as a polyvinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride, which is also called as PVC. Okay, so we can see over here that it is prepared by polymerization of, we can say it is prepared by polymerization of vinyl chloride in presence of peroxide. In an autoclave. Under pressure. Okay. So this was our last type of addition polymer that we need to study over here, preparation of this. And while studying these polymers, one thing that you keep in mind is that you concentrate on these equations. Very simple, very easy. If you know this, you can write down this in your own words. Okay, so we stop over here today. Thank you, students.